But how long did it last, Hammond?
This will last about 2 weeks. Turned out to be a good game. 90% chance of rain, so I guess we were lucky and we got that 10% chance. Now to get back and work on this drawing. To on a rainy day have a warm coffee, put on a film. At the moment I'm starting to watch the new Borat film that's just come out, and just sit and draw for hours. There's just something about working on a cold rainy day, being inside drawing, that I've always loved. And I've decided to set up my artwork over here first. My big green 35 shades of green illustration that I'm working on, so that I can just start to sketch out and map out where each element of the artwork is, and then later I'll move it over to the desk and continue to add in the detail. I'm really excited for this project. I think it's going to be absolutely awesome, and I hope you guys are going to enjoy watching the progress. Okay, it's all set up. This is one of the most exciting parts of any artwork, right at the beginning. A large, fresh, clear, white piece of paper. All the ideas, all the possibilities. It's really exciting. And this project I'm doing, I'm using 35 shades of green to create this artwork. So what I'm thinking to do is to research different green motifs and Australian animals and things that are going to relate to the Granny Smith Festival or tie into it seamlessly for the artwork so that it makes sense. Obviously there's going to be a lot of Granny Smith apples throughout the illustration, but I'm just thinking of other elements that I can include that visually will look really good. This will be the first time I've ever done an illustration using entirely one color. So that's what I find really, really exciting. I've done black and white artworks before, but I've never done anything where the entire artwork is comprising just of green. So aside from the apples and all the different elements and hidden things that I want to put into this artwork, what I'm really excited about is how I can use as many shades of green as possible and create contrast by putting different colors next to each other and make it bold and striking by just mucking around with the color, basically. I really don't enjoy planning and knowing entirely what an artwork's going to look like. And for a very long time, I used to just sit down and draw and make it up as I go along. And what I've tried to do over the last couple of years is still adhere to that sort of strategy, but at the beginning of an artwork, do a little bit of research, print out some ideas or inspirational images that will get the creative juices flowing, and also will be little references that I can use when I'm starting the artwork so I stay on topic. And as I do start to look up the ideas and look for green elements and green animals and green things that I can include, then the ideas and creativity really just starts to flow. So that little element of planning that I've started to do at the beginning of artworks has I've actually noticed that my work has improved quite a lot. Now the rest of the time, I'll just sort of freestyle and wing it and change the artwork as it progresses. Thank you. now, because I've relegated myself to entirely green, parrots like this will be out of the question. I can probably get away with drawing something like this. I can get a green which is close enough to that, and the very, very dark, almost black greens can work. So the three overarching themes or components of this artwork are the color green, 35, as in 35 years of the actual festival, and the apple. So those are the three components that I'll research and try to get ideas on how I can creatively install them into this artwork. And when you're doing research, you end up on all these crazy websites like 10 facts about the color green. And, you know, I never really know if I'm gonna find something that will inspire me from this or will generate some form of idea, but that's sort of what the research section of an artwork is. I don't spend weeks doing that. I usually just spend 1 or 2 days, depending upon how big the artwork is, researching, looking into the themes and the ideas, and then start building the creative sort of structure of the artwork from those ideas. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you're enjoying these daily YouTube art videos. If you haven't as yet, feel free to subscribe to my channel. And if you do have any art related questions, you can pop them below. I'll respond to absolutely everybody. Tomorrow, I am planning on compiling all this research on the color green, the Granny Smith apple, and all the elements that I want to include in this large illustration. And then I think we might be ready to start adding some green to the paper and get cracking with the drawing. Thanks for watching. See you guys tomorrow.